I am Dr. C. Chandrasekhar Reddy, Assistant Professor, Department of General Surgery. Today's topic is acute cholecystitis. So this occurs in patients with pre-existing chronic cholecystitis, or it may occur as a first presentation only. So the usual cause is impacted stones in the Hodgman's pouch. Coming to classification, it can be acute calculus cholecystitis or acute acalculus cholecystitis. These are the two classifications. Mode of infection is hematogenous through hepatic artery, cystic artery, or portal vein, through bile via portal circulation. The causative organisms are E. coli, most common, Klebsiella, Pseudomonas, Streptococcus faecalis, Salmonella, Clostridium welschi. So this is the diagram of gallbladder with acute infection of the gallbladder in a laparoscopic view, you can see. This is also on the table photo of distended gallbladder. You can see the carotid triangle. The upper margin, superior margin of the liver, the cystic artery lower down, and hepatic, common hepatic duct forms the carotid triangle, you can make out. So here the gallbladder is inflamed. Coming to pathogenesis. Stone in the Hodgman's pouch or cystic duct causes obstruction. This obstruction leads to stasis. It leads to edema of the wall. So bacterial infection occurs, leads to acute cholecystitis. So impacted stone also causes mucosal erosion also. Thereby bile salts act on submucosal tissues. This toxic bile leads to necrosis, infection and perforation. Complications of acute cholecystitis. Perforation 5 to 10%, which usually occurs in the fundus or in the neck. It can cause cholecystoduodenal, cholecystointestinal, or cholecystobiliary fistula, or Meriges syndrome. So peritonitis, pericholecystic abscess also can form. Cholangitis and septicemia are other complications. Empyema, gallbladder, gangrenous gallbladder, or other complications of acute cholecystitis. Coming to emphysematous cholecystitis, seen in elderly male patients, common in diabetic and immunosuppressed persons. Clostridium welschi and E. coli, streptococci are common organisms. Ultrasound and CT scan are diagnostic. Gas is seen in the gallbladder. In emphysematous cholecystitis, you can see the gas inside gallbladder. The results in life-threatening septicemia leads to pulmonary cholecystitis, gangrene, perforation, peritonitis also occurs. Emergency cholecystectomy is required in this case. Coming to clinical features of cholecystitis. Sudden onset of pain in the right hypochondrium with tenderness, gouging and rigidity. You can palpate gallbladder, which is tender. A Boas sign is positive. Boas sign is hyperesthesia between 9th and 11th ribs, posteriorly on right side. Jaundice may be present, fever, nausea present, tachycardia, toxic features may be seen. Murphy's sign may be positive. Murphy's sign is when you palpate in the right hypochondrium, patient in sitting position, at the height of inspiration, patient will wince with a catch in the breath due to the inflamed gallbladder touching the fingers. Coming to investigations, ultrasound abdomen very useful, reveals presence or absence of gallstones, thickening of the gallbladder you can make out. Sonographic Murphy's sign may be positive. Plain X-ray of the abdomen, 10% of gallstones are radio-opaque. Gas is seen in emphysematous gallbladder. Total count shows neutrophilia. Hedo and Pipida radioisotope study very useful. Non-visualization of gallbladder is diagnostic. LFT increased bilirubin implies cholangitis, stone in the CBD. Coming to differential diagnosis. Duodenal perforation, acute pancreatitis, acute appendicitis, acute pyelonephritis, lobar pneumonia, acute myocardial infarction, ruptured ectopic pregnancy. These are the differential diagnosis for acute cholecystitis. Coming to treatment, advise hospitalization immediately. Initial conservative treatment like nasogastric aspiration, IV fluids, analgesics, antacids, antispasmodics, broad spectrum antibiotics like cefepime, ceftazidime, ceftriaxone, cefotaxime, plus amikacin, metronidazole are given. Observation and follow up ultrasound scan, and after 3 to 6 weeks interval, open or lap cholecystectomy is done. Emergency cholecystectomy or cholecystostomy is done if the patient is having empyema gallbladder, that is pus in the gallbladder, persisting and progressing symptoms, not responding to conservative treatment, emphysematous cholecystitis, perforation and peritonitis. So if cholecystostomy is done because of difficulty in getting a carotid triangle, dense adhesions, cholecystostomy is done, and cholecystectomy is done after 3 weeks, that is interval cholecystectomy is done after 3 weeks. There is a changing trend towards early cholecystectomy in acute cholecystitis within 48 to 72 hours. So laparoscopic cholecystectomy is a gold standard now. Coming to acute acalculus cholecystitis. So it is common in patients who had undergone major surgeries, trauma, burns, any other stress, or in cases of cholecystosis. Common in ICU patients, in critically ill patients. It is due to bile stasis and ischemia. Common in AIDS, elderly, male diabetics who have undergone major non-biliary surgery, patients who are on total parenteral nutrition. May be seen in malignancy also, biliary or other malignancies. Exact cause is not known. Pathology is edema and necrosis of the gallbladder with features of acute inflammation. Presentation is usually acute. Gangrene, perforation, empyema are also common here. Investigations, ultrasound abdomen and isotope study, HIDA scan. Percutaneous ultrasound or CT guided or open cholecystectomy, later cholecystectomy is the treatment of choice in acute acalculus cholecystitis. Coming to Meige syndrome. So it is seen in 1% of all cholecystectomies. In this, the impacted stone is in the Hartmann's pouch, causes pressure necrosis, which further gets adherent to common hepatic duct and common bile duct wall. It causes compression and later cholecystocolitocol fistula, that is from gallbladder to bile duct, cholecystocolitocol fistula. Presentations are patient present with fever, abdominal pain, obstructive jaundice, tenderness over the right epicondrium, soft enlarged liver may be palpable. Investigations, ultrasound abdomen, CT scan, ERCP, MRCP to delineate the duct anatomy, HIDA scan is also useful. There are types of Meige syndrome. There are 5 types. Type 1 is 10%. Here, extrinsic compression of common bile duct, common hepatic duct by a large impacted stone in the Hartmann's pouch. Treatment is subtotal cholecystectomy with ERCP stenting. Type 2 is 40 to 50%. Here the stone eroded 1/3 the circumference of CBD or CHD, forming fistula. Treatment is subtotal cholecystectomy with CBD exploration. Type 3 is 20 to 30%, involving 2/3 the circumference of the CHD CBD. So subtotal cholecystectomy with CBD exploration is the treatment. Here is a diagrammatic representation of the type 1 and type 4. So type 1, the stone compressing the common hepatic duct. Here type 4 is, you can see the fistula formation between the gallbladder and common hepatic duct. Type 4 is 2 to 5%, involving entire circumference of the CBD or CHD with cholecystocolidocal fistula. This needs hepaticojejunostomy. Type 5 is 15 to 25%. Here cholecystocolidocal fistula with cholecystoenteric fistula with or without gallstone ileus. So cholecystectomy with hepaticojejunostomy is the treatment in type 5. Now to empyema gallbladder. So it is a type of acute cholecystitis wherein gallbladder is filled with pus. It may be sterile in 30% of cases. It can occur in pre-existing mucosal where it gets infected. It is commonly observed in impacted stone, diabetic persons, immunosuppressor people like HIV, long-term steroid therapy. Condition has got high mortality. So this is the empyema gallbladder. You can see the stone and pus. Clinical features: fever, toxicity, pain and tenderness in the right hypochondrium will be there. Tender, smooth, globular gallbladder palpable in the right hypochondrium. Complications are septicemia, rupture and peritonitis. Investigations: ultrasound abdomen, radioisotope scan, hematocrit, LFT, PTINR, total count is raised. Treatment: initial cholecystostomy and later after 6 weeks cholecystectomy is done. Cholecystostomy is draining the gallbladder with externally, that is cholecystostomy. Mucosal of the gallbladder: it is the overdistension of the gallbladder containing mucoid or clear fluid. It is a non-inflammatory distension due to impacted stone in the cystic duct and rarely due to polyp or carcinoma or extrinsic compression, congenital narrowing of the cystic duct, parasitic block like Ascaris, prolonged total parenteral nutrition. So due to obstruction in the cystic duct, absorption of all the bile occurs and secretion of the mucus into the gallbladder allows the gallbladder to distend, causing mucosal. Content is usually sterile. So this is a mucosal. You can see the mucoid material in the coming from the gallbladder, mucosal of the gallbladder. Clinical features: dyspepsia with painless swelling. There will be no pain just because it's sterile here. There will not be any pain. So it is a painless swelling in the right hypochondrium, which is non-tender, smooth, soft, globular, palpable gallbladder, which often reaches down to the pelvis also. Very big mucosal also can occur. Differential diagnosis: cholecystocolidocal cyst, mesenteric cyst, hydatid cyst, pseudocyst of pancreas can all mimic this one. Complications: empyema gallbladder, perforation, biliary peritonitis can occur. Rupture can cause pseudomyxoma, peritonei can occur. Investigations: ultrasound abdomen, LFT, CT scan, MRCP. Treatment: open or laparoscopic cholecystectomy is done. Coming to chronic cholecystitis, it is chronically inflamed, thickened gallbladder which is non-functioning and non-distending. Causes are gallstones, cholecystosis, acalculus cholecystitis. Organisms, Klebsiella, Streptococci, Salmonella. Pathology, gallbladder is shrunken, small, contracted and fibrotic with thickened gallbladder wall. Mucosal proliferation into the lumen creating deep clefts projecting into muscular wall lined by epithelium called Rokitansky-Ossoff's sinuses. Clinical features, pain in the right hypochondrium may be colicky or persistent pain, flatulent dyspepsia, intolerance to fatty foods, positive Murphy's sign as patient in sitting position on deep inspiration while palpating in right hypochondrium, patient winces with pain at the summit of inspiration. Same sign in the lying down position is called Moynihan's sign. Complications, CBD stones, pancreatitis, cholangitis, Meriggi's syndrome, carcinoma gallbladder. Differential diagnosis, peptic ulcer, pancreatitis, hiatus hernia, carcinoma biliary system, GI malignancy. Investigations, ultrasound abdomen shows stone with posterior acoustic shadowing with thickened gallbladder. Isotope study, ERCP, CT scan often required. Treatment, laparoscopic cholecystectomy. Gallstone ileus. It is a type of acute intestinal obstruction often seen in elderly and is due to blockage by a bolus or mass of stone, gallstones, which enter the intestine through cholecystoduodenal fistula or rarely cholecystointestinal or gastric fistulas. Clinical features, pain abdomen and features of intestinal obstruction like vomiting, distension, constipation. Stones may perforate ileum to cause peritonitis also. Investigations, erect exabdomen shows air in the biliary tract and multiple air fluid levels of intestinal obstruction you can make out. Ultrasound abdomen and CT abdomen are diagnostic. Treatment, laparotomy, enterotomy, that is opening the intestine, removal of the gallstones and closure of the enterotomy is done. If bowel is ischemic, resection and anastomosis may be required. Cholecystectomy, correction of fistula with T-tube drainage can be done in the same setting if general condition of the patient is good. Otherwise, it is done after 12 weeks. Coming to cholecystectomy. So, it is the surgical removal of the gallbladder. Indications for cholecystectomy are gallstones, symptomatic, cholecystitis, acute, chronic, acalculus, empyema or mucosal of the gallbladder. Prophylactic cholecystectomy is done in diabetic patients, congenital hemolytic anemia and in patients who underwent bariatric surgery. In gallbladder malignancies also cholecystectomy is done. So these are the incisions used for cholecystectomy. One is that red one showing is usually common incision, that is Cocker's incision, Cocker's subcostal incision, and the Mayo-Robson incision, the transverse incision, vertical incisions, midline incision. So these are the incisions used for cholecystectomy. Approach, there are two approaches, one is open, another is laparoscopic approach. Of course, laparoscopic is the gold standard for cholecystectomy nowadays. So open through right subcostal incision, already told you Cocker's incision, right paramedian midline incision, horizontal incision, Mayo-Robson incision. Technique. So in open incision through right subcostal incision, abdomen in open in layers. There are two approaches, one is fundus and another is through cystic duct approach. Cystic duct approach, first the callus triangle is delineated, cystic artery and cystic duct identified in the callus triangle and they are ligated, and then the gallbladder is lifted from the base of the liver and removed. This is the duct first method. In fundus first method, in difficult cases wherein there are dense adhesions, you cannot make out where the cystic artery or duct in the callus triangle. In that case, you will go for fundus first method, where the gallbladder is approached through the fundus. Yes, the fundus is lifted from the bed of the liver, and then cystic artery, cystic duct identified, ligated, and removed. This is the open method of cholecystectomy. If there is any infections and severe infection, perforation, something else, we need a subcostal, right? Drain is kept in the subhepatic space. And in a laparoscopic approach, there are four ports are introduced into the abdomen, one through umbilicus where the telescope is passed, another through the midline epigastric where it is used for operating, and these two are 10 mm ports and two 5 mm ports, one in the anterior axillary line and one in the mid axillary line are used. Through these ports, through lateral port, lateral 5 mm port, fundus of the gallbladder is held with forceps, and through another lateral port, the Hartmann's pouch is held, and this is how the dissection is done. The gas is introduced inside up to 10 to 14 millimeters, then 14 mm, and then Kallers triangle is approached, cystic artery, cystic duct dissected, ligated with clips, and gallbladder is removed from the bed of the liver, and any bleeding points are attended. So complications of both open or laparoscopic include these are complications. These are infection and subphrenic abscess can occur, bleeding from cystic artery and from liver bed, injury to common bile duct or hepatic duct, bile leak and biliary fistula formation, biliary stricture formation also can occur, injuries to colon, duodenum, mesentery. Thank you.